My dear students, this is Sir Gaur Dhiman. Again, welcomes you all in our path Maths Online Classes. So dear students, we are doing chapter number 11, which is known as conic sections. And in this topic, we have completed three types of the conic section, which was your circles, number one, number two, parabola, and number three was your ellipse, which was discussed in the last video. So today we are going to start the last type of the conic section, last curve shape figure, which is known as your hyperbola. For illustration of hyperbola, let us consider two fixed points. These are the two fixed points, that these are F1 and F2. And let us consider two fixed lines as well, that these are the two fixed lines, that these are denoted by L1 and L2. Then hyperbola is the locus of all those points. The ratio of the distances from the fixed point and the fixed line, that should be or greater than 1. This is something like this. This is the locus of all those points. The ratio of the distances from this fixed point to the fixed line, that should be or greater than 1. And similarly, this will be or like this. This is the ratio of the fixed line to the fixed line, fixed point to the fixed line, should be or more than 1. Let this is your F1, this is let the P point, let this is your S, and this is your again S dash, let this is your P dash. So the path followed by all those points, the ratio of the distances from this fixed point to the fixed line, that should be always more than 1. And it is mathematically can be denoted by PF1 upon PS, that should be greater than 1. And this is, you know very well, is known as eccentricity. The ratio which is your taken from this fixed point and the fixed line is known as eccentricity. So the value of eccentricity should be greater than 1 in case of hyperbola. The midpoint of these two foci is known as your center of the hyperbola, and this is your taken as your y-axis, and this is your considered as your x-axis. So if the two fixed points which are known as focus are lying on the x-axis, then this type of hyperbola will be known as your horizontal hyperbola. And in a similar way, if the fixed point are lying on the y-axis, then this type of hyperbola is known as your vertical hyperbola. These two fixed points are known as your foci of the hyperbola, as it was discussed in your ellipse also. Ellipse mein bachcho do fixed point the, to fixed points ko focus bolte hain, because these are the two fixed points, so these are called as your foci. And the fixed lines are known as directrix. Foci are the fixed points. Fixed lines are known as directrix. These are the fixed line from which the distance ratio is to be measured, and this ratio should be or more than 1. Now the point which intersecting this path, which intersecting the x-axis, is known as your vertex. This is your known as vertex of the hyperbola. This point is your known as center of the hyperbola. The axis through which these foci are passing means the fixed points which are to be taken on the axis is known as your transverse axis. Transverse axis. So this x-axis is known as your transverse axis. This is your transverse. And the axis or the line which is perpendicular to the transverse axis is known as your conjugate axis. So if these are the foci, the axis is measured along your x-axis, because the foci are on your x-axis. So this is your symmetric along x-axis. If this is foci are lying on your y-axis, then this is your symmetrical about your y-axis. Now, dear students, what will be your length of lattice rectum? This will remain same length of lattice rectum in case of whatever it is, your parabola, ellipse or hyperbola. Length of lattice rectum is the distance between the path followed by the points passing through the foci, like this. This is your something like this. So this is your the length of the lattice rectum, and which will we will find. So this was the basic of your the hyperbola, and depending upon the foci lying on the fixed points, this is your termed as two types of the hyperbola. Number one is horizontal hyperbola, and number two is vertical hyperbola. And vertical hyperbola will be your denoted like this. I am just plotting the diagram of vertical hyperbola, and this will be something like this. This is your, the fixed points are here, the fixed lines are here, then the locus of all the points whose ratio from this fixed point to the fixed line are more than one, and this is something like this. So this is your known as the vertical hyperbola. Now let me describe the descriptions of the these two types of the hyperbola through a table. I'll tell you what is the equation of hyperbola, what are the foci, what are the vertices, what is length of lattice rectum, what is length of transverse axis, what is length of conjugate axis. So first of all, let me draw the diagram of the hyperbola. This is for your horizontal and this is for your vertical. Horizontal hyperbola is given by this one, and this is your the vertical hyperbola. This point is your 0, 0. This point is a, 0. This is your -a, 0. This is 0, a. This is 0, -a. And directrices are your here. These are the equation of directrices like this. Now diagram is something like this. What is your equation? Equation of hyperbolas. This is given by x² / a² - y² / b² is equal to 1. But in this case, the equation of hyperbola is given by y² / a² - x² / b² is equal to 1. My dear students, let me differentiate in between of hyperbola and ellipse. Ellipse ke case mein, the value of a is always greater than b. Jo a ki value hoti hai, hamesha b se greater hoti hai. Aur jis bhi variable ke niche agar wo badi value hai, usi ke along hamara ellipse hota tha. But in case, this is totally depending upon the first variable. This is x² / a² - y² / b² A will be always in the first position, and b will always on the second position. This is b square, sorry. So this is your, if x² / a² - y² / b² is there, this is your along x-axis, means horizontal hyperbola is there, and this is your the vertical hyperbola in which y should be first and x will be your after that. Now this is the equation. Now let me write on the vertices. Vertices are given by +/a, 0, and in this case this is 0, +/a. Foci again given by +/c, 0, and here this is 0, +/c, and c can be obtained by a² + b² under the root here. In case of ellipse, this was a² - b², but in this case this is your a² + b² under root. Now next is length of transverse axis. It is same as length of major axis was 2a, and this is your 2a again. Now what is length of conjugate axis? this is given by 2b as it was in your ellipse, length of minor axis. This is remain same as length of major axis was there in case of ellipse. This is your now length of transverse axis. This is your length of transverse axis. Ye hai transverse axis. And this is your conjugate axis. In the same case, this is your transverse axis, this is your conjugate axis. Now what is length of lattice vector? This is given by 2b square by a, and this will remain same as 2b square by a. Now what will be the equation of directrices? Equation of directrix is also remain same as it was in your ellipse. X is equal to plus minus a upon e, and this is y is equal to plus minus a upon e. And the last one, eccentricity, we can find the value of eccentricity by c upon a. Eccentricity in both the cases, hyperbole, and in case of ellipse, it is given by e is equal to c by. So many things are very much same, very much similar as it was in your ellipse. Only difference is there in the value of c, where c in this case hyperbola ke andar c ki value a square plus b square root hoti hai, aur ellipse ke andar it was a square minus b square root. The equation is also having difference with your the equation of ellipse. Yahan par x square minus y a square minus y square by b square hota hai, aur jo pehli value hai wo a hogi, chahe wo choti a value hai chahe wo badi value hai. So this was the basic of your related to the hyperbola. We can do some questions based on the topic hyperbola, which is your exercise 11.4. Now we can take some example. Let me take an example. How can you differentiate whether it is your horizontal hyperbola or the vertical hyperbola? And that will depend upon the variable which is your placing at the first or the second. So let me take an example. This is x square by 4 minus y square by 16 is equal to 1. Dear students, this is your the case of hyperbola, which is your horizontal hyperbola, in which the value of a will be 2 and the value of b is your 4. So this can be written as the value of a is your 2 and value of b is 4. So we can find all the concepts, all the terms which are related to this hyperbola. If you want to find the vertices, vertices given by plus minus a comma 0, so this is plus minus 2 comma 0. If you want to find the foci, foci ke liye pehle c ki value nikalni padegi, aur c ki value nikalne ke liye this is given by a square plus b square, means 2 square plus 4 square under the root, and this is your 4 plus 16 under root, which is your root 20, and this is 2 root 5. So the value of c is your 2 root 5. So in case foci are to be find, this is your given by plus minus 2 root 5 comma 0. Length of transverse axis is given by 2a, which is your 2 into 2, 4. Length of conjugate axis is given by 2b, 2b means 2 into 4, that is 8. Length of lattice rectum is given by 2b square by a. By putting the value of a and b, we can find the value of length of lattice rectum. And the equation of directrices will be given by plus minus a upon b, aur uske liye mujhe pehle e nikalna padega, aur e ke liye we have the formula, e will be given by c. The value of c is 2 root 5 upon a is your 2. So this is the value of e is your root 5. So my dear students, you should have to take care about the value of e. E should be or more than 1 in this case. Hyperbola case mein e hamesha 1 se bada hoga, aur ellipse ke case mein e is always less than 1. So in this way, the center of this hyperbola is given by 0 comma 0. This is your no doubt. So my dear students, in this way we can start the exercise 11.4. Let me do a question based on the exercise 11.4 from your NCERT book. For that, let's see the question number 1. Question number 1 from your exercise 11.4. The first question states that we need to find the coordinates of the foci, the vertices, the eccentricity and the length of lattice rectum of the hyperbola. And equation is given by the equation is given by x square by 16 minus y square by 9 is equal to 1. This means let's compare this given equation with the standard form as x square by a square minus y square by b square is equal to 1, and this is the hyperbola which is your along x-axis, and along x-axis means this is your horizontal hyperbola, and the value of a we can find as your given by 4 square minus y square by 3 square is equal to 1. So value of a is 4, value of b is your 3, and let me find the value of c also, which can be given by a square plus b square under the root. And this is your a square means 16 plus this is 9 under root, which is square root of 25, and given by c is equal to 5. So by getting the value of a, b and c, we can write down each and every term which is related to hyperbola. First of all, let me find the vertices. Vertices of this hyperbola is given by plus minus a comma 0, which is given by plus minus 4 comma 0. Foci are given by plus minus c comma 0. So this is given by plus minus 5 comma 0. Now next is your length of transverse axis is given by 2a, which is your 2 into 4, which is 8, and length of conjugate axis is given by, this is simply 2b means 2 into 3 is equal to 6. Next we want to find the eccentricity is given by e is equal to c by a, c is your 5, a is 4, so value of e is your 5 by 4. So value of e is your 5 by 4, and length of lattice rectum also we want to find. Length of lattice rectum, which is given by 2b square by a, and this can be obtained by putting the value of b, which is your 3 square upon a is your 4, so this is 2 into 9 by 4, cancel out, this is 9 by 2. So length of lattice rectum is your 9 by 2. So in this way we can do the questions, and question number second also can do by yourself. So this is your homework to do the question number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Dear students, you can do by yourself question number 1 to 6, and if any problem faced by you, you can call me or can give me the WhatsApp. So till then, thank you and have a nice day.